Hi, this is Asing. You are now watching Asing Math TV. In this video, we will learn how to factorize a degree 5 polynomial completely. First, enter the function given. We have 15x to the power of 5 minus 44x to the power of 4 minus 55x to the power of 3 plus 176x squared minus 44x minus 48. We know that at point x, when x is a 0, which means that the function should equal to 0. So what we have to do here is press alphabet calculate to get the equal sign, and we should set it to 0. Shift calculate to solve. Solve for x, press equal. Then we will obtain the root negative 0.4. Press the number negative 0.4 and we should obtain the fractional number. So from here we can see that x equal to negative 2 over 5 is a 0, which means that if we bring everything to the left, minus bring over become plus 2 over 5 is equal to 0. Then x plus 2 over 5 is a factor. By using synthetic division or long division, we should reduce a degree 5 polynomial to a degree 4 polynomial. So we should obtain 15x to the power 4 minus 50x to the power 3 minus 35x squared plus 190x minus 120. Since if let's say we want only integer, but this is fractional number, so what we have to do here is refer to the denominator. We need to times a 5, so which means that we have to factorize 5 from this degree 4 polynomial, and we should obtain 3x to the power 4 minus 10x cubed minus 7x squared plus 38x minus 24. Then we just have to times this 5 to the factor and we should obtain 5x plus 2. And this is how we obtain the factor 5x plus 2. Once we already reduced a degree 5 polynomial to a degree 4 polynomial, then the rest of the steps will be very simple. We just have to press menu, down and down, look for the equation function, press equal, look for polynomial to degree 4, and we just have to enter these coefficients accordingly and we should obtain the rest of the roots. So we have 3 equal negative 10 equal negative 7 equal 38 equal negative 24 equal. Equal again, we should obtain x1 is equal to 3. Down, x2 equal to 4 over 3, down, x3 equal to 1, and x4 equal to negative 2. With all these roots, we just have to move backward and we should obtain all the steps as we can see here. So the idea here is, for example, if we have x is equal to 3, to obtain the factor, we just have to bring everything to the left. So which means that plus 3 move to the left, we obtain x minus 3 is equal to 0. So this is the factor that we need. And so for the rest of the roots, once we obtain the factors, we just have to multiply them to get back to the previous step and multiply them to get back to the previous step. And we have all the steps here. Okay, that's all for this video. Thanks for watching. Hope you like this. See you.